Let's look at using a t-table to find areas and percentiles for the t-distribution. Suppose we need to find the 2.5th and 97.5th percentiles of a t-distribution with 6 degrees of freedom. The first thing we should do is plot in the appropriate t-distribution and draw in what we're looking for. We can do this roughly by hand, but I'm going to give the exact distribution using software here. So here's a t-distribution with 6 degrees of freedom. And by the definition of a percentile, the 2.5th percentile is the value of the variable that has an area to the left of 2.5%, or 0.025. And that's going to be somewhere roughly around there, the value of the variable that gives this area to the left of 0.025. We don't need to get it exactly right on when we're drawing it in at this point, we're just looking for a rough idea of where it is. Similarly, the 97.5 percentile is the value of the variable that has 97.5% of the area to the left, or 0.975. And since the area under the entire curve is 1, this implies the area to the right of the 97.5 percentile is 0.025. And so that's going to be somewhere around here. The 97.5 percentile is going to be the value of the variable that has an area to the right of 0.025. So let's go to the table and find those values. Here's my t-table. Some t-tables have slightly different formats. And here we have the degrees of freedom down the left-hand side. And to give us a little bit more room to work with, I'm going to restrict it here to the smaller degrees of freedom. Recall that one of the values that we need to find is the t-value with an area to the right of 0.025 under a t-distribution with 6 degrees of freedom. And so we're going to focus in now on this 6 degrees of freedom line. And the way the t-table is set up, it gives values of t in the body of the table with a certain area to the right. And we need to find the area to the right of 0.025. So this is the appropriate column, and if we go down here, we would see the value that we need is 2.447, so that is this value. Note that the t-table does not give any negative values of t, and that's because the t-distribution is symmetric about 0, so we can easily find values in the left tail by relying on the symmetry about 0 argument. For example, if we wanted to find the value of t such that the area to the left is 0.025, we could say, wait a minute, it's symmetric about 0, and so this value here with an area to the left of 0.025 must be minus 2.447. And so, using the t-table, we found the values that we need. The 97.5th percentile is 2.447, and the 2.5th percentile is minus 2.447. What is the area to the right of 1.8 under a t-distribution with 5 degrees of freedom? I'm going to draw in a t-distribution with 5 degrees of freedom this time, and put in 1.8, which is somewhere around there, and we're looking to find this area to the right. So let's go to the table and find that. We need to find the area to the right of 1.8 under a t-distribution with 5 degrees of freedom. So this area here, where the degrees of freedom are 5. And so we're going to focus in on this 5 degrees of freedom line. When we walk along this line, we are not going to find 1.8 exactly, but we do find these two values that surround 1.8. Why is this important? The t-table tells me that the area to the right of 1.476 is 0.1. And so if we drew that out, 1.476, the area to the right is 0.10, and the area to the right of 2.015 is 0.05. So the area to the right of 2.015 is 0.05. And our value of 1.8 falls in between these two values. So it stands to reason then that the area to the right of 1.8 must lie between these two values. So the table tells me that the area to the right of 1.8 under a t-distribution with 5 degrees of freedom lies somewhere between 0.05 and 0.10. And if we needed to get the exact value, we'd need to use software. And if we went to software, we could find that the area, to 5 decimal places, is 0.06588. What if we needed to use the t-table to find the area to the left of 1.8? Well, since the area under the entire curve is 1, the area to the left of 1.8 is 1 minus the area to the right of 1.8. So, based on the table, we could say that the area to the left of 1.8 under a t-distribution with 5 degrees of freedom must lie somewhere between 0.90 and 0.95. What is the area to the left of minus 5.2 under a t-distribution with 9 degrees of freedom? Well, I'm going to draw in a t-distribution by hand this time and say here's our t-distribution, roughly speaking, and 0 is right in the middle, and minus 5.2 is out here in this left tail somewhere, and we're looking to find the area to the left of that value. But recall that the t-table does not give negative values of t. So before going to the t-table, we need to use the symmetry about zero argument and recognize that the area to the left of minus 5.2 is exactly equal to the area to the right of 5.2. And so we're going to have to find this area in the table. We need to find the area to the right of 5.2 under a t-distribution with 9 degrees of freedom. And we're going to focus in here on the 9 degrees of freedom line. And if we walk along here, we'll see that the biggest value we find in the table for those degrees of freedom is 4.781. And so the table tells me that at 4.781, this area out in the right tail is this value, 0.0005. And since our value of 5.2 is even farther out in the tail than this value, we know that this area must be less than 0.0005. And so the table tells me that the area to the right of 5.2 is less than 0.0005, which implies the area to the left of minus 5.2 is also less than 0.0005. If we needed to do better than that, we could use software to find out that the area to 5 decimal places is 0.00028.